गुड इवनिंग डियर फ्रेंड्स, वी आर बैक विद डीप टॉक्स मेंटल हेल्थ डॉक्टर मिस कुरलीन खोखर एंड डॉक्टर दीपक पुरी, हुज अ कार्डियक डॉक्टर इन सुपर स्पेशलिटी मैक्स हॉस्पिटल मोहाली. आई एम वेरी ऑनर्ड टू हैव सर्व विद मी ऑन डीप टॉक्स, विच इज अ वर्चुअल स्टेज ऑन लव एंड रिलेशनशिप्स. इज गोइंग टू बी रियली फन कॉन्वर्सेशंस बिकॉज दे आर टू डॉक्टर्स who are wanting the viewers to watch us. It's something called psychological independence on conversations. So I welcome you, Dr. Deepak Puri, on this virtual stage of love and relationships. Sir, may I ask you, what is your take on stress in relationships?
Good evening, Dr. Gurleen. It's a great
Good
pleasure
evening.
to be here with you today.
Good evening.
Stress is very important nowadays because it is the root cause of most of our problems, whether it is a health problem, physical health problem, or a mental health problem. The root cause behind it is stress. So if we talk in general terms, I equate stress to a situation like you are walking on a road and suddenly a dog starts running after you. So what do we do? So there are two kind of responses. Either we fight or we adopt the flight. Flight means we run away. So for both the situations, our brain gets activated and
True.
signals are sent through our bloodstream to the entire organs of the body.
True.
Our muscles, they start contracting at a very faster rate with a great force. Blood circulation increases, the heart rate increases, our blood pressure rises, sugar is generated, reaches the bloodstream at a higher level because all the organs, all the muscles, they need energy so that we can run as fast as possible or we can fight as well as possible so that we can defend ourselves.
True.
So stress, that is what I call stress. But in our actual life, there are situations when we keep on worrying without reasons. And it is a similar situation where, like, we are asking a dog to run after us all the time. So if
True.
we have a dog running after us all the time, entire day, and most of the time in the night also, people are not able to sleep. So the same adrenaline is circulating within our circulation. Our blood sugar rises, blood pressure rises, and that leads us towards so many diseases, like the risk of getting diabetes increases, the risk of getting hypertension, high blood pressure increases, risk of heart disease increases, risk of
True.
going into other diseases like cancer risk also increases,
True.
depression level go high, suicidal tendencies increase. So in a way we mess our life because worrying doesn't help us, stress doesn't help us, but some amount of stress is essential because what is known as the eustress stress or the good stress. So that
True.
helps us in increasing our efficiency. But when we
True.
stretch it beyond a limit, then we reach a
True.
stage when we plateau our efficiency, and after that the decline starts. And that is the stage when our functions, they become affected, and we are not able to do our work in a proper way. We are not able to hold on to relationships in a good way. So we mess up our lives and we land up with so many diseases, physical as well as mental diseases. And then we reach a breakdown stage. And then that is very dangerous. So I would just like to advise the viewers that stress is good to only a certain extent. So don't stretch it beyond that.
Very true. So, sir, can you enlighten us on the issues of increase in the heart diseases related to breakups and toxic relationships? Because I've recently been dealing with counseling cases, and there have been youngsters coming to me with issues of breakups, love affairs, with a lot of high BP, a lot of tension in their mindset. Is it related to heart issues as well? I mean, are you dealing with it in this certain proportion of the reality which is there? Can you just enlighten us and the viewers on the same?
Definitely. We get a lot of patients, especially youngsters, who come to us with symptoms that are similar to heart disease. They can get shortness of breath, palpitation, and many people, they even get chest pain. And sometimes when we examine them, we find that they are otherwise absolutely looking normal. And many tests also are conducted. And sometimes even the echocardiography can show that the pumping of heart is not as good as it should be. And the heart also takes a different kind of a shape. So this we used to wonder why this happens. But actually, the person is too young to get a heart disease. And then sometimes in some patients who were in a very bad shape, angiography was done. And we found that angiography is absolutely normal. So we used to wonder that what is this that is causing all these problems. And then the Japanese, they term this condition as Takotsubo cardiomyopathy. So this is a unique kind of a term that is given to heart disease and the symptoms that occur because of some heart failure. So when, if you go into the depth, many times some young, especially this is very common, much more common in young females. So if you interrogate the person and take the proper history, then we find out that is some kind of a heartbreak or some stress or some adverse event that has occurred recently in their life,
sure.
because of which this has the impact on the heart. So fortunately, they need just a kind of a psychological support, and only few may need some medication also. But most of them, they can recover fully well within short period of time if they are given the proper support, if they are reassured.
Wonderful. So as a cardiac doctor, what could be the tips to remain healthy from the heart? Our viewers would love to know.
Definitely, I would love to share with the viewers that there are three main causes of death nowadays, which everyone should stay away from. The number one cause of death is smoking. So tobacco smoking in any way, it is very bad, and it has become the number one cause of death across the globe. The number two cause of death is obesity. In many countries, obesity is number one cause of death also. So many people, they must be laughing at the idea, how can obesity be a cause of death? But I'm telling you, it is medically proven that it is one of the topmost cause of most of the lifestyle diseases as well as death. And at number three, everybody must be surprised to hear that alcohol is ranked as number three cause of preventable death. So if we stay away from these three factors, and if we take a very healthy, balanced diet that is rich in fruits and vegetables, and less of calories, less of salt, less of sugars, less of fat, so it will help us in having not only a healthy life, but also it will increase our lifespan. And
that's a wonderful tip.
Apart from that, physical activity is one very important factor. So just simple walking for half an hour every day, it reduces the risk of getting heart disease by 60%. So it is very simple to walk half an hour. But I am sorry to say that most of us, we just don't go for that. We have a very sedentary lifestyle. And nowadays, sitting has also come up as one of the risk factors for getting lifestyle diseases. So
true.
Everybody should know that 17 million people, they die every year because of heart disease across the globe. And lifestyle diseases, they are the number one cause of death. So what is more important is that 80% of these problems, they are preventable. So if
True.
we have to just take simple tips, which we don't advise very difficult tasks, just simple tips, so that you can take care of your health and avoid all these things that I've told. And apart from that, stay away from stress.
Wonderful.